Give us your reaction to everything that happened out there tonight.
Well, I think it went well. I laid out my case about the work that I've been doing in Washington, going to bat for our working families and small businesses, fighting to lower costs, protect health care, lower the cost of prescription drugs. But look, I think there's a few days left in this campaign, and we're just excited to get out, to be around New Hampshire, and continuing to be, delivering this message to the people of New Hampshire about how we can work together to solve challenges. And I think that was the one thing that, came out of this debate for me. I think Caroline Leavitt didn't give us solutions when it comes to lowering costs for families. She gave a lot of good political attack lines, but not much more than that. And I think the voters of the state deserve substance and someone who understands these issues and can actually work on them in a concrete way.
To you, what was the biggest issue on that stage out there tonight?
Well, I think there were a number of them, from making sure that we're protecting the progress that we've made on renewable energy development, that we're fighting to lower costs and having fiscally responsible policies in Washington. And also, I think the distinction on who's going to be representing the women and men of this state that are pro-choice, that want someone in Washington who's going to represent and reflect their values. That exchange that we had on a woman's right to choose, I think, is pretty telling. She continued to say that legislators in Concord, politicians should be making this decision. I think it's a private personal choice. And I hope people were watching, because I think a lot of folks in New Hampshire care about that issue and are going to vote on it.
Final days of this campaign, we're almost being able to count by the hours at this point in terms of until Election Day. What do you need to make sure you do to be sent back to D.C.?
Well, we're going to be everywhere the next 5 days, and we're going to be very active on Election Day, too, meeting voters out at the polls. And look, New Hampshire never disappoints. We always have one of the strongest turnouts in the country. We're a state where people are really engaged in these issues, and times are tough right now. There are significant challenges in our economy with rising energy prices, with low vacancy rates for rental apartments that are driving up housing costs, workforce shortages for small businesses. It's going to take someone who's worked on these issues, who understands the challenges firsthand, and who's going to work in a bipartisan fashion to address them. So that's what we want to continue to be talking about these next few days, and we'll find people wherever they are.
So finally, what is the closing message in this campaign right now?
Well, I think the difference in this campaign is between me as a bipartisan problem solver and Caroline Leavitt, who's an extreme candidate, an election denier, and someone who's a partisan bomb thrower. She can't name one issue where she differs from President Donald Trump. I named maybe a dozen things tonight where I've stood up to Joe Biden and my party when they're wrong for New Hampshire. And that's what this is going to take. To be successful representing and reflecting the diversity of opinions here in New Hampshire, we need someone who's going to listen to everyone, who's going to work to synthesize that into policies that will make a difference. And I'll always work across the aisle and stand up to big oil and big pharma and work to change the way Washington works. I think a lot of people have frustrations about the pace of business in Washington, and we've got to make sure that Washington is reflecting the challenges that are out there and finding solutions. That's what I want to do, and I'll always put New Hampshire first in that effort.
Thank you.
Thanks, Steve.